Good afternoon, Year 4s. I'm Declan.
And I'm Bennett. Together with Marvin and Ray, we'll be your MCs for today.
It's our pleasure to welcome you here today.
Today, we wave a heavy goodbye to the Year 1 4 campus as we start a new chapter in our lives. But first up, we have some exciting events coming up, so stay tuned while you enjoy your food.
Today, we will begin with addresses from Mr. Lee, followed by performance by two different bands, and an Ask Me Anything segment where you can ask two lucky teachers anything you wish.
Coming up for you now, we have Mr. Lee's final address to our batch.
Okay, gentlemen, yeah, this is authentic, so one take. As you can see, I'm perspiring, so the previous takes were not successful, most probably. So this is where it all began, and this is how we'll probably say goodbye to you, lah, and how I will say goodbye to you right now. So in a blink of an eye, 3 years, 11 months, 4 days have passed. How do we sum up 4 years worth of experiences? I really can't, because it's just too many days and it's too long. There's just too many adventures, too many stories to tell, and many lessons that were learned along the way as well. So I chose to record the final piece here in the hall, because this is where it all began for you. This is where it all began for you. Your first days were spent here in the Albert Hong Hall during your orientation phase, and I actually wanted you to have your batch dinner here at the same time this year to mark the end of your journey here at the Year 1 to 4 campus. But things weren't meant to be, but that's okay, we adapt, because we are Invicta. So your Invicta journey began with introducing you to the ways of the Rafflesian, with the help of your PSL brothers who worked tirelessly through November and December of 2016 to ensure you had a good start to your Rafflesian careers. During the Year 1 orientation, we played games, learned about the DNA of a Rafflesian, and cheered through the 3 days and two nights in a blaze of camaraderie. I also played tag with you guys in the rugby field. I remember running after Bohan, if memory serves me well. If it's Bohan, I think it's Bohan. So at the end of the orientation camp, during the Junior Rafflesian Investiture Ceremony, or the JRIC for short, your form teachers pinned your badges and inducted you to the ways of the Rafflesian. Proudly, and I had the honour of leading you in the singing of the badge song. You found your CCAs, became part of a brotherhood pertaining to what piqued your interests, attended the various school and badge events, went for match supports, and so on and so forth, right, to wave the school on and to cheer the school on, and cheered your batchmates on as well. Your first year as a Rafflesian then ended with your participation in the end of the year inter-house activities, amongst other events like the Deepavali decorations, to name a few. The start of the year 2 saw you build sandcastles with your classes, and you ended the year dragon boating with your year 2 classmates one last time. I believe there's also a batch games or inter-house games at year 2 as well, if I'm not wrong. Then year 3 saw an extended PIT with your form teachers, learning about MBTI, and the year's highlight was the Outward Bound school experience, Outward Bound Singapore experience, sorry, where you met new friends from other schools and you learned to be independent. This was followed by a street dance activity in October and an esports experience. So that was year 3. Then for year 4 this year, we started the year with bubble soccer, because last year was cancelled, right? Of course it rained out, I believe. And the batch dance at the start as well of this year. Really wanted to have an opportunity to showcase the batch dance, so maybe you can try it at year 5 instead. So we have hoped to have given you an interesting experience outside the classroom so that you fondly remember your year 1 to 4 experience. This year saw COVID-19 try to take away our year 4 experience, but we did not bow down, and we showed the spirit of tenacity, resilience and adaptability, and showed why we are the Invicta batch. We will not be conquered by negativity, and we will always look at the positives. When you look back, do not remember the negatives. Remember the many teachers who worked hard to help you through the 4 years. The hard work your teachers put in to stand you in good stead to embark you on your year 5 adventures, and the many times they stayed back for you and worked with you. Remember the good friends you made, Remember the laughs, the silly moments, and the moments Mr. Lee had to scold you all in the hall, the auditorium, lecture theatre. Yeah, these few places. And hush. Yeah. So remember, embrace the memories, embrace the friendships forged, and remember to be a gentleman through it all. Be the best gentleman you can be for yourself, your family, your friends, and the community at large. So I hope you look back at your 4 years fondly and remember all the teachers, friends, and your parents who journeyed with you through these 4 years. Do come visit your teachers and me. We will always be here physically or virtually. So that's it. This is where it all began. And this is where I will end this speech as well, right? Symbolically. So auspicium melioris saevi. All the best. Good luck at year 5. Remember to come visit. Again, auspicium melioris saevi. Take care. And remember to come visit, yeah? Bye.
Thank you, Mr. Lee, for your speech. I'm sure we all share the same sentiments as our year ahead. On behalf of everyone, we would like to express our utmost gratitude to Mr. Lee for putting up with our batch shenanigans with patience and care.
At the same time, we treasure the memories and experiences that we've shared with each other throughout the 4 years. As we grew, so did the world around us. As we learned, we uncovered more about how the world worked.
Now, let's sit back and enjoy Elliot and his band perform Hotel California. Performing this classic, Trina on acoustics, Colin and Hunter on electric, Donald on bass, Mr. Lee on vocals, and Elliot on drums.
There's a highway, cool wind in my hair, warm smell of pimientos rising up through the air. Up ahead in the distance, I saw a shimmering light. But if you hear me in my sacred dear, I had to stop for the night. There she stood in the doorway, I heard the mission bell. Thinking to myself, this could be heaven or this could be hell. Then she lit up the candle and she showed me the way. There were voices down the corridor, I thought I heard them say, welcome to the Hotel California, such a lovely place, such a lovely face. Plenty of room at the Hotel California. Any time of year, you can find it here. Her mind is Tiffany twisted. She got the Mercedes Benz. She got a lot of pretty, pretty boys she calls friends. How they danced in the courtyard. Sweet summer sweat. Some dance to remember, some dance to forget. So I called up the captain, please bring me my wine. He said, we haven't had that spirit here since 1969. And still those voices are calling from far away. up in the middle of the night just to hear them say, welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place, such a lovely face. You're living it up at the Hotel California. What a nice surprise. Bring your alibis. Mirrors on the ceiling, pink champagne on ice. And she said, we are all just prisoners here of our own device. And in the master's chambers, they gathered for the feast, stabbing with their steely knives, but they just can't kill the beast. Last thing I remember, I was running for the door. I had to find a passage back to the place I was before. Relax in the night, man. We are programmed to receive. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave.
Amazing.
We know you want more,
so we'll give you more. Coming up by Tisa and his band, We Are the Champions by Queen.
We have Anza on the electric guitar, Jixiang on the acoustic guitar, David on the bass, Suya on the drums, and Joel on the vocals.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my share. We are the champions.
have taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But it's been a bed of roses.
Wow, that was amazing. I guess we're moving on to the next segment now.
Not so fast, Ray. Before we move on to the Ask Me Anything segment, we have one final performance by none other than our year head, Mr. Lee. Accompanying Mr. Lee on the guitar is Colin, and they will be bringing you a very memorable song.
That's right. They'll be bringing to us Memories by Maroon 5. Let's all reminisce and thank the friends that we've made along the way, the experiences that we've been through, and the lessons that we've learned. And drink up, because drinks bring back memories.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, because the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember, when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever, and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December, when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day. Yeah, everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Hey, but everything will be alright. Go and raise a glass and say, hey, here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember, when I never felt so lost, when I felt all the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feel like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, cause you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Hey, hey. Everything gonna be alright. Go and raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Memories bring back, memories bring back you. Memories bring back, memories bring back you. Yeah. Memories bring back, memories bring back you.
Wow, that was amazing. Who knew Mr. Lee had that in him, man? Tennis doubles champions, your head, and now rising singer. What can't he not do?
Our teachers really do have many hidden talents. Although we may tire of them both in person and online, they too have a playful and fun-loving side.
Our teachers have been an integral part of our four-year-long journey. Be it from studies or values, they have taught us and imparted us with many lessons. Of course, it's not easy for them, as we don't exactly give them an easy time in class.
As a result, they repeat themselves over and over again. Seeing how this may be the last time we see some of our teachers, they have recorded these messages for us as a form of farewell to our batch. Sit back and enjoy the video.
How many times must I tell you?
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 Year 4s, how many times must I tell you
that whatever life throws at you, we take it and we do the best that we can with it?
How many times must I tell you that it is important to be a useful citizen of the country?
How many times must I tell you, alright, that math is not about solving equations and getting the answer? No! Right? Math is about looking for patterns.
How many times must I tell you, read the source carefully?
How many times must I ask you to take away your phone? Are you with me?
How many times must I tell you to keep quiet when I'm giving instructions?
How many times do I have to tell you this? We teach you philo and train you in logic precisely so that you will become a critical thinker and be an agent of good reasoning and an agent of change for good.
How many times must I tell you, lai liao is not a word. It's neither English, nor Singlish, nor Chinese. Never mind.
How many times must I tell you to answer the question?
How many times must I tell you to give your answers in 3SS?
How many times do I have to tell you need a topic sentence for every single one of your paragraphs?
How many times must I tell you not to give out on math too?
How many times must I tell you to circle the gamete? Circle the gamete!
How many times must I tell you that Africa is not a country?
How many times must I tell you, you are the best?
How many times must I tell you, when I retire, I'm going to sell coconuts in an island?
Hi Year 4 2020. It's been a pleasure for me knowing your batch. And to all the students and classes I have taught, thank you. I have learned many things from you, and I hope you have learned some things from me. All the best in Year 5, 6, and of course the A-levels. And see you around in campus next year and the year after.
Abuse your intelligence and skills and you will become what? Can you remember? That's right. Don't you dare go out there and be a critical stinker. I don't mean to belabor the point, but I want to say it again. Remember, people won't respect you for your GPA, your grades, or how much material possessions you have. But they will respect you for your character and the values that you uphold. And that is how you can be mad, by holding firm to your principles and values and believing that you can make a difference. To paraphrase a quote by the founder of the Scout movement, Lord Baden-Powell, I wish for all my students to always endeavor to leave a place in a better condition than when you first found it. I would like to wish all of you, our graduating year fours, a great trip ahead. May it be an exciting and fulfilling journey for you all the way. Remember, be good and do good. And don't do anything illegal or immoral. In a nutshell, don't don't do anything that your fellow teacher won't approve of.
Dear Year 4s going on Year 5s, excluding gaps and courses, you're the first batch of Year 4s that I've taught, so thank you for that virgin experience. I've taught philosophy to almost half of you before, and for 4B and 4E, I have the privilege of teaching philosophy and SS together for 2 years straight, another virgin experience for me. Some of you I have taught during Gap Sem or chaperone during the Taiwan trip end of last year. Others come under my charge because you're a swimmer or a polo player. If nothing else, I've seen you straggling down the corridors, and for some of you, I've taken to task for being too cocky. Along the way, you have moved me, inspired me, and made me a more decent person. You have moved me when you showed signs that you actually cared about what I'm teaching. You have moved me when you have showed signs of kindness, loyalty, or moral courage. You have inspired me when I observed your passion shining through and delivered beyond what a teacher could reasonably expect of a 15 to 16 year old. You have made me a more decent person as I try to live up to the standards of decency I set for you guys. But above all else, you guys have annoyed me. Many of you guys sleep in class, or stare at your crotches and claim you're using your handphones, or laugh at the wrong time, or laugh for too long. Having said that, I'm sure most of you are better people and better friends than you are students. And arguably that matters more. What I'm trying to say is that I'm sure I'll like many of you a lot better if I did not have to teach you guys. Lastly, the obligatory words of advice. I've thought long and hard about the following advice and I mean them with all my heart. I have two advice and I'll keep them brief. Right? The first advice is grow up children, get a life. The second advice is passed down from the decades from my own PSL once in Sec 1. And it's still relevant to me now as an adult and a teacher. Right? That is, don't grow up too fast. I won't spoil the poignancy of these words of wisdom by elaborating further. So I shall end off here with just my well wishes. So wishing you an eventful journey at year 5, 6 or wherever else you may be headed, filled with happiness and educational disappointments and a fulfilling life thereafter.
Let me take this opportunity to congratulate the batch of 2020 for making it through a difficult and trying year and pretty much unscathed. I hope that you have come through this year especially a little bit wiser, a little bit more mature, a little bit more aware of people who are different from you, from different backgrounds, with different means. I hope that you have used this opportunity to also get to know your family a little better. I want to share with you some parting words. I hope that through these 4 years, you've grown to be a little bit more grateful for the blessings you take for granted, you and I take for granted, like family, friends, being able to come to school safely. And I hope that as you step into this next season of your life, I want to say all the best. I want to say every success, I hope every success follows you. And most importantly, I hope that you stay physically and mentally healthy, that you will stay hungry, not in the jug of food sense, but that you feel always a thirst and a hunger for knowledge and wisdom, and that ultimately you will stay humble, knowing that you are always a work in progress. I like to say this to my classes, that education is like a running a marathon. It's not about how fast you start, but how consistent you are and how you run and finish this race. So all the best to the batch of 2020. You've done very well. I hope you press on, and I hope you stay safe. Take care, and God bless.
So obviously I'm speaking to all of you with regard to your Gap 2020 experience. And I know that when we started the entire journey, I'm sure all of you were really, really looking forward to it, right? We were too, as the teachers and myself. But of course, you know, life doesn't always turn out the way that we want it to. But do we throw our hands up, cry and whine and stuff? Of course not. We do the best that we can with the situation, we make the best of it, and we still come up on top of the entire situation, right? So I know that while Gap 2020 wasn't exactly the experience that all of you wanted to, but from my conversations with some of you, I really am very heartened to hear that it was still meaningful for some of you, that you were still able to take things away from your Gap experience, and for that I really am heartened. So with regard to, you know, this is an analogy of what life actually is going to throw your way. I hope that you'll be able to approach any challenges that you have in life, any situations and changes and stuff with that same adaptability, that same can-do spirit. And of course, my very wish is to wish you guys the best and hope to see you guys around then. Thank you.
Hey, you are not leaving RI. You are still in RI. Just going to a different side. Okay, you are going to have new adventures in RI. Okay, we hope that over the past 4 years, your experience over here in 1-4 has prepared you well to serve the people that you'll be meeting down the road over on the other side. Okay? I just want to leave you with one word. Okay, this is the word that I've been using with you over the past 2 years, past 4 years. Okay, that word is respect. If everybody treats everybody else with respect, I think the world, the school, is going to be a very much better place.
I hope you have enjoyed your journey here at Year 1-4. The next 2 years could be more fast-paced, a bit more stressful, a bit more exam-oriented. But don't just focus on the academics. Hopefully, you'll find some time to be yourself, right, to pursue the things that you like. Yeah. So my message is just be yourself and enjoy the journey.
Hi Year 4s, thank you for giving me the privilege to be able to teach all of you this year. As you move forward to the next leg of your journey in Year 5-6, I just want to wish you guys all the very best. While you guys are pursuing academic excellence, studying hard, chasing your dreams, I also want to remind you guys to look at life beyond your grades. I think that you guys should develop the joy of learning, enjoy your subject, and also do the things that you are truly passionate about. So I just wish that you guys will continue to look at the wider society, at your family, and your friends, and think of the things that you can do for them. So I think that you guys should not just worship your academic results, but really think of your role as a citizen. What can you do for your family? What can you do for the wider society? And I think this is the true value of education, being able to give back to the society. So I just wish you guys all the very best. And remember to come back and visit us again.
Especially to my RPAC Year 4 boys and my AP students, as well as my form class, 1I, 4 years ago, you are the best. Okay, and I always tell Mr. Eugene Lee that I enjoy teaching you about a lot. And some of them, when they talk to me, they say, "Are you sure or not, ma'am? Are we really that good?" I say, "Really, you are really, really that good." Okay, and not to mention, one of the best CEC I work with, Zijin, you are the best.
Having said that, I'm glad some of you made it this far. Happy graduation, yeah, guys. I just want to say again, congratulations. I'm so glad that I got to teach you guys this year. I will really miss seeing all of you. Okay, please come and visit. Stay in touch and. Do call me or message me if you need anything. Yeah?
Congrats on finishing your 4 years here. I'm glad that I got to teach some of you guys in year 2 and year 3, although it was a little bit shorter than I anticipated, but I think it was overall like a really good experience. There were very positive memories, some maybe more painful experiences, 3G 2019, but at the end of the day, I'm still thankful for the memories. Okay, I'll look back and laugh on these days one day. But yeah, I really hope that you guys have enjoyed your time here and wishing you all the best as you move forward to year 5, 6 and beyond. Yeah, I mean, even though you might be leaving the school, do know that you're always welcome back here and that you can always come and look for us and talk to us if you ever need to.
Hi Year 4, I've taught you all for 4 years and many of you have grown up and have matured over the 4 years. So continue working hard for JC and remember to try your best.
Hey boys, I had so much fun being your teacher, mentor, and also as your second family. All the best.
All the best, Year 4s, in your future endeavors. Good luck and see you soon.
Do or do not, there is no try. All the best to your future, Year 4s.
So it's important all of us actually have dreams, no matter how big or small they are. Today for your graduation, I'm going to sing you a song. It's called Kyo no hi wa sayonara. Itsu
Thank you, teachers, for all that you've done for us in the past 4 years. We'll be forever grateful for the time and effort that you put into teaching us.
Well, we're nearing the end of this segment, but before we go, we have one last performance. Zixiang and his band will be performing for us one last time this afternoon. They'll be performing Ganbei by Mayday.
For non-Chinese speakers, the song title translates to cheers. As you listen to the heartfelt lyrics, please reflect upon their experiences and the friendship that you've forged throughout the past 4 years. Quick reminder though, as most of you guys have probably finished your food, to please compact the food packages and dispose of them properly.
After the performance, your CCs will be taking over. Have fun with your classes and enjoy your final time together as a class. We will catch you guys later for one final song. For now, here's Zixiang and gang with Ganbei.
干一杯。
时间真的能倒退，退回你的我的回不去的悠悠的岁月。也许会有一天，时间真的有终点，也要和你举起回忆酿的甜，和你再干一杯。再干一杯，再干一杯，永远喝了就能万岁。岁岁和年年，时间都停了，他们都回来了。怀念的人啊，等你的来到。时间都停了，他们都回来了。
So does our time as a class and as a batch with only the boys. In honor of that, we will have a throwback to the very beginning of our batch, 4 years ago.
Remember all those years back, when we stood in the hall, arms around each other's neck, receiving our badges for the first time. Seems like quite a distant memory, isn't it? At the end of JIIC was Mr. Lee on the stage, performing to us the batch song.
And now, Mr. Lee will bring us back the very same batch song that we had 4 years ago, together with Joel Chick and Justin Chua. Take it away!
Voice
What a heartwarming rendition of the batch song that is. It feels like the cycle is complete. From us being year ones at our orientation camp, to us being big brothers to the new batch of year ones and theirs. It really does feel like we've come full circle.
Of course. And for our finale, we will be having our institution anthem for the last time as year fours. We'll have Daniel Ching over the PA system soon.
For now, that's it from us today. We hope you enjoyed this batch lunch and will treasure this moment as well as countless other memories you've made over these past 4 years.
Thank you.
Bye.